Hello viewers, in this video I'll discuss the next topic under averages, which is weighted average. Here I will discuss the meaning of weighted average and solve some practice questions. Now first we will see the meaning of weighted average. If we have n quantities x1, x2 up to etc. xn with corresponding weights w1, w2 up to etc. wn, then the weighted average of these is given by, it is the product of the weight and their quantities all added together. So it is w1 x1 plus w2 x2 plus up to etc. plus wn xn upon the sum of their weights, w1 plus w2 plus up to etc. plus w1. Or it is given by summation wi xi divided by summation wi. Now if the weights are given in percentage, say p1 p2 p3 up to etc. pn, then the weights are given by, it is the percentage into the corresponding quantity. So it is p1 x1 plus then p2 x2 plus up to etc. plus pn xn, or it is equal to summation pi xi. Now using this formula we will solve some problems. The first question: in a certain exam a weightage of 6 is given for max and 4 is given for English. If a person scores 80 marks in max and 75 marks in English, then calculate the weighted average of marks. So it is given in some exam, a weightage of 6 is given for max and 4 is given for English. So the weights are W1 is 6 and W2 is 4. And if a person scores 80 marks in max and 75 marks in English, so here X1 is 80 and X2 is 75. We have to calculate the weighted average of marks. So the weighted average of marks, it is nothing but, it is W1 X1 plus W2 X2 upon W1 plus W2. So here it is 6 into 80 plus 4 into 75 divided by 6 plus 4. So this is nothing but, this is 780 upon 10. So the weighted average marks is 78. So this is the weighted average of marks. The next question: Mohan has a general store and earns a profit of rupees 3000 from the groceries, rupees 1800 from vegetables and rupees 1000 from fruits. He assigns a weight of 5 to groceries, then 3 to vegetables and 2 to fruits. He wants to predict his profit for next month. Calculate the weighted average of profits. So we have a person who is having a general store and earning a profit of rupees 3000 from groceries, 1800 from vegetables and 1000 from fruits, and he assigns some weights to each of these. He wants to predict the profit for next month. So we have to calculate the weighted average of profits. So the weighted average of profits, it is given by summation wi xi divided by summation wi, or this is equal to, here the weight for groceries is 5 and the corresponding profit is 3000. So it is 5 into 3000 plus, then the weight for vegetables is 3 and the corresponding profit is 1800. So 3 into 1800. Then plus the weight for fruits is 2 and the corresponding profit is 1000. So plus 2 into the weight into the profit divided by sum of the weights, that is 5 plus 3 plus 2. So here when we multiply all these and add, we get 22,400 divided by So it is 15,000 plus 5,400 plus 2,000. So it comes to 22,400. Here 5 plus 3 plus 2 is 10. So the weighted average of profit is rupees 2,240. The next question, a school uses the following metric to promote students to the next class. The minimum required score is 50. If John gets the scores as given below, will he be promoted to the next class? So these are the various metrics which a school uses: assignment, quiz, then midterm exam, project, and end term exam. The corresponding weight for each of these metrics is 5%, 10%, 30%, 15%, and 40% respectively. The score which John has obtained in each of these is: in assignment he has got 90 out of 100, in quiz 85 out of 100, in midterm 73, in project 87, and in end term 78. So we have to see whether John will be promoted to the next class or not. It is given the minimum required score is 50. So we have to see whether John scores above 50. If he scores above 50, then he will be promoted to the next class. So here the final score is calculated as summation pi into xi, where pi is the percentage and xi is the score. So the weight for assignment is 5% and the score is 90. So it is 5% into 90 plus 10% into 85. The weight for quiz is 10% and the score is 85. Then we have the midterm exam. The weight is 30% and score is 73. So 30% into 73 plus 15% into 87 plus 40% into 78. So this is equal to 5% is 0.05. So it is 0.05 into 90 plus 0.1 into 85 plus 0.3 into 73 plus 0.15 into 87 plus 0.4 into 78, or this is equal to 4.9 plus 8.5 plus 21.9 plus 13.05 plus 31.2. So based on the weightage in assignment, he gets 4.9 in assignment, 8.5 in quiz, 21.9 in midterm exam, 13.05 in project, and 31.2 in end term exam based on the weightage. If we add all these, we will get the final score. So when we add all these, we get 79.45. Now this is more than 50. So if it is more than 50, then he will be promoted to the next class. So more than 50, therefore John will be promoted. I hope this video was useful for you. Thank you for watching.